the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, God's truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
Yes, ma'am.
Right, you're Brett McAlpin, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Mr. McAlpin, you understand if you're under oath, yes, be sworn in, so that doesn't be a person.
Yes, sir.
All right, on August the 14th of 2023, you pled guilty to count one of hindering prosecution in the first degree, and count two, conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
All right, that guilty plea was accepted there by the court. Pre-sentence investigation report was ordered. We've received that here today. We're here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Both counsel have the pre-sentence report.
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
Any,
yes, Your Honor.
Any additions or corrections on it?
None from the state, Your Honor.
Not on behalf of Mr. McAlpin, Your Honor.
All right, Mr. McAlpin, at the time of your plea, I told you in that guilty plea that I was not bound to any plea bargaining agreement, but to impose the maximum sentence. You recall that?
Yes, sir.
You said under oath that you did understand that. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
You understand that I am not accepting the state's recommendation today. I've rejected that recommendation. But it's my understanding that the attorneys have met after I informed them that I have rejected that recommendation, and they have amended the recommendation. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is there anything from the state or the defense before I go into sentencing?
Nothing from the state, no.
Anything from the defense?
Your Honor, just I would state, and speaking with Mr. McAlpin, he would respectfully ask the court to honor the original plea. He understands that the court is not accepting it, but I wanted to make that statement on his behalf, but he understands that the court has final say, as he did in this plea for the court previously.
Is that correct, Mr. McAlpin?
Yes, sir.
All right, anything else?
No, sir.
All right, as to count one, hindering prosecution in the first degree, it will be the order this court serve 15 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include a victim's fund fee of $1,000, fine of $5,000. Count two, conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree, will be the order this court serve 5 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include payment of court costs and expenses.
$431.50
for a total of $6,431.50. All will be paid within 2 years after release from custody. You also will be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute the attached affidavit we will have for you for surrender of your transmissions to the Board of Law Enforcement Officer Standards and Training. Counts one and two are run concurrent. Both counts run concurrent to any federal time also.
Thank you. Right.
Anything else?
No, sir, Your Honor.
All right.
May I be excused, Your Honor?
Yes. All right, 33-524, State versus Jeffrey Middleton. Conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree. Do you recall that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, that guilty plea was accepted and entered by the court. Pre-sentence investigation was ordered and reviewed, and we're here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, both counsel have received a copy of that PSI. Is that correct?
We have, Your Honor.
Any yes, Your Honor.
Any objections or additions to it?
None from the state, Your Honor.
None from the defense.
All right. All right, Mr. Middleton, at the time of your plea, your guilty plea that you made here, I told you at the guilty plea that I was not bound by any recommendation, that I was not bound by any recommendation that could impose the maximum penalty. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. All right. You understand that I said that, and you said under oath that you understand it. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. You also understand that today I'm rejecting that recommendation made by the state. It's my understanding that the attorneys have gotten together after I informed them that I rejected that and agreed to amended recommendation. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay.
Your Honor, the state did make an amended recommendation, but as with Mr. McAlpin, my client rejects that, and he does understand the court's ability to go above the recommendation that it rejected.
All right, thank you. All right, anything from the state? Anything from the state or the defense department since?
Nothing from the state, Your Honor.
No, Your Honor.
All right. To count one Henry prosecution in the first degree, it would be the order of this court to serve 15 years in custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include payment of a crime victim's fund of $1,000, a fine of $5,000, and court cost assessments.
$431.50
for a total of $6,431.50. All to be paid within 2 years. Release from custody. You'll also be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute the attached affidavit for surrender of your submission to the Board of Law Enforcement and Officers Training Standards and Training. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, counts one and two run concurrent, both on run concurrent to the federal time. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, do you have any questions?
No, Your Honor.
Anything else to say?
Your Honor, I think the court needs to pronounce this.
I apologize. As to Henry prosecution in the first degree, the order supports you to serve 15 years in the custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. And count two, conspiracy to commit Henry prosecution in the custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you for that. I apologize to the prosecution in the first degree. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That guilty plea was accepted and entered by the court. Pre-sentence investigation was ordered, and we're here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Counsel, you received a copy of the PSI. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
State received a copy.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Anything from the state or the defense as far as any objections or additional?
None from the state, Your Honor.
None from the defense.
All right. All right, Mr. Devlin, at the time that you entered your plea before me, I told you that I was not bound by any plea bargain agreement, but could impose the maximum sentence. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
You also said under oath you understood that. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You understand that today I'm rejecting that recommendation. It's my understanding that the attorneys have met, and after I told them I was rejecting that recommendation, come up with a new recommendation that they've agreed to. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, do you have anything from the, is anything from the state or the defense before going to sentence?
Your Honor, the court, Mr. Dedman understands the court has the right to reject the initial plea offer, and he's accepted the supplemental plea offer.
Nothing else from the state, Your Honor.
Okay, Mr. Dedman, it's according to, let's see, it's count number one, burglary. It'll be the order of this court to serve 20 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include the payment of a crime victim's fund of $1,000, fine of $5,000, and as to count two, conspiracy to commit hindering the prosecution in the first degree, it will be the order of this court, that you serve 5 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include the payment of court costs and assessments.
$431.50. $431.50.
$431.50 for a total of $6,431.50. All will be paid within 2 years after release from custody. You'll also be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute attached affidavit for surrender transmission to the board of law enforcement officer and standard training. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
All right, counts one and two run concurrent. Both run concurrent to federal time. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any questions?
Yes, sir.
All right. Counsel Lieberman?
No, Your Honor.
Stay.
No, Your Honor.
All right. Thank you.
May we be excused?
You may. State versus Hunter Elward. Accepted, entered by the court. The pre-sentence investigation was ordered. We received that here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Both counsel received a copy of that pre-sentence investigation. Is that correct?
We did, Your Honor.
That's correct, Your Honor.
Were there any additions or corrections on it?
No, Your Honor.
Okay. All right, Mr. Elward, at the time of your plea, I told you in that plea that I was not bound by any plea bargain agreement to impose the maximum sentence. Do you recall that?
Yes, Your Honor.
You also recall that you did agree to that under oath?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. You understand that today I'm rejecting that initial plea offer, but it's my understanding that there has been an additional amended plea offer that I believe you've seen. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. All right. All right. Anything from the state or the defense before I go on sentencing?
Nothing from the state, Your Honor.
Not from the defendant, Your Honor.
All right, Mr. Elward, as you ag assault, count one, it'd be an order of this court to serve 20 years in the custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. The city conditions include a crime victims fund, payment of $1,000, fine of $5,000, and we'll do court cost assessment for everything. Count two, burglary, it'd be an order of this court to serve 20 years in the custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. And count three, conspiracy to commit hindering the prosecution of the first degree, it'll be the order of this court to serve 5 years in custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include the payment of court costs and expenses.
$431.50
for a total of $6,431.50. All be paid within 2 years after release from custody. You'll also be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute the affidavit of surrender of transmissions to the Board of Law Enforcement and Officer Standard and Training. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Counts one, two, and three were run concurrent to the federal time also. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you have any questions?
No, Your Honor.
All right.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Yes, sir. All right. 33-527, State versus Daniel Opdyke. Thank you.
will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help me God.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, you're Daniel Opdyke, is that correct?
Yes.
All right, Mr. Opdyke, you understand you're under oath against the sworn incident penalty of perjury, you understand that?
Yes, sir.
All right, on August 14th of 2023, you pled guilty to count one of hindering prosecution in the first degree, and count two, conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree. Do you recall that?
Yes, Your Honor.
That guilty plea was accepted and entered by the court. The pre-sentence investigation report was ordered. I've received it. We're here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right, at the time of that plea that you made here, I told you at that guilty plea that I was not bound by any plea bargain agreement to impose the maximum sentence. Do you recall that?
Yes, Your Honor.
You said under oath that you did understand that. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Right, you also understand that today I'm rejecting that plea offer. It's my understanding that attorneys have met and have an additional plea offer. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Anything from the state or the defense before I go into sentencing?
Nothing from the state, Your Honor.
Nothing from the defense, Your Honor.
All right, thank you. All right, Mr. Opdyke, is count number one, hindering prosecution in the first degree. It'll be the order of this court to serve 15 years in custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include payment of a crime victim's fund of $1,000, fine of $5,000, and court costs and assessments.
$431.50.
And as to count two, conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree, is order this court to serve 5 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include the payment of court costs and expenses, which includes that $431.50. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
For a total of $6,431.50. All will be paid within 2 years after release from custody. You'll also be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute the affidavit of surrender for the transmission to the Board of Law Enforcement and Officer Standards and Training. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any questions?
No, sir.
Anything else from the state or the defense?
Your Honor, you didn't mention it, but two sentences, the 15
yes,
years and five,
were concurrent. Thank you, sir. Yeah. Counts one and two run concurrent, and also run concurrent to the federal time. Anything else?
No, sir.
Thank you. That's the sole reason that I asked, is there anything else?
Yes.
I appreciate y'all doing that. All right, 33-528, State versus Joshua Hartfield. Conspiracy to commit hindering prosecution in the first degree. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Your guilty plea was accepted and entered by the court. A pre-sentence investigation was ordered. Received that, reviewed it. We're here today for sentencing. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
Both counsel received a copy of the PSI?
State received it, Your Honor.
Yes, Your Honor.
Any additions or corrections on that?
No, sir.
No, sir.
All right, Mr. Hartfield, at that time that you entered the guilty plea before me, I told you that I was not bound by any plea bargain agreement to impose the maximum sentence. Do you remember that?
Yes, sir. Okay.
You also said under oath that you did understand that. Do you recall that?
Yes, sir.
All right. You understand that today I'm rejecting that plea recommendation made by the state, but it's my understanding that the attorneys have met after some discussion, and I informed them that I would not accept that plea. They come up with a new plea that I think you've seen. Is that, or excuse me, a new recommendation that you've seen? Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right, is anything from the state or the defense for the one citizen?
Nothing from the state.
Nothing from the defendant, Your Honor.
All right, SD count one Henry prosecution in the first degree will be the order this court serve 10 years in custody of Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include payment of crime victims fund $1,000 and a fine of $5,000. As count two, conspiracy to commit entering prosecution in the first degree of the authorities court that you serve 5 years in the custody of the Mississippi Department of Corrections. Specific conditions will include payment of court costs and expenses.
$431.50
for a total of $6,431.50. All be paid within 2 years after release from custody. You'll also be required to permanently surrender your law enforcement certificate and execute an affidavit for the surrender for the transmission to the Board of Law Enforcement and Officer Standards and Training. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
All right. Counts one and two are run concurrent. Both are run concurrent to any federal time. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir. Your
Honor. Any questions?
No, sir. Your
Honor. Anything from the state?
Nothing from the state, Your
Honor. No, Your Honor.
Okay.
Let me excuse you, Your Honor.
Yes, you may. All right, anything else we need to take up in the state or the